What's up, guys?
We're trying to do a cold air intake modification for a pseudo spark with not a lot of money. See, we already had it taken already all apart, and we did some modifications right here and right here. We are using a 2-inch fuel filter hose pump, and over here there was a honeycomb like filter in there, and we took it out because it restricted the airflow and it might give you some more RPMs or a little bit more speed. And right now we're just hooked it up right there. The air box is right here. We're gonna drill through the air box right here. So this run through is this. And I'll be back in a couple seconds. I'm back, and I just forgot to tell you that we had to cut a little bit of the tube off to make this work. Here's all the parts of the intake that we were going to use, but we found out it was easier to use the fuel filter hose. Right now, the fuel filter tube. What? Okay, he was just cutting a piece of steel off. Should we make it longer? We shoot the blue one. Or make two of them. That'd be cool. That'd need more air. Right?
What?
If we put two of them on. Like if
the idea is just to get cold air from the front. That's it. It's not going to get you any more air. It's just going to get you cold air.
More cold air, right?
I'm just going to strap this. Just like that.
Make sure there's nothing in it though too before you put it on. Look at it, we can open the box and then just cut it straight through, or just feed that through.
Alright. I just wish this was a little longer. That's what she said.
I will be right back. Hey, you guys are getting a 2-for-1 because we're about to do an exhaust too. We're not done with the cold air intake, but we're trying to find, because we don't have that many exhaust parts or air intake parts, we're trying to see what we can use and for the exhaust and what we can't use for the exhaust. So I'll be back in a couple minutes. Hey guys, I'm back, and we just took off the muffler, and we're seeing where if we needed that, and it said we didn't really need it, and this is probably what we're going to be using, just the putt pretty much. You take the takeoff muffler. There's a couple bolts that'd be right here and back there, I think. And right now, we're just looking right now. We're going to cut this straight across, so make it a little bit shorter. Here we go. I'll be right back. Guys, we're back. We're about to cut it with the sawzall. Just straight down the middle. I'll be right back when we're done cutting. Okay, I'm back. We just cut right through that piece right there. There's where it got cut. Straight down the middle right there and straight right there.
Modify this to make it work a little bit. Okay? Way you don't have to buy nothing. It's made with shit we got laying in the ground.
I'll be back. And we're just hooking up the... We're trying to find how to hook up the exhaust. We're cutting the zip ties off right now, but be careful that you don't cut the wire when you cut it off, because that would suck.
And if you cut them short like this, you can reuse them.
I think there's water supposed to be in that. There. I get the adapters. And I will be back. Yeah, I'm back. We just got found some adapters for a cold air intake just sitting around. So we're gonna try and make them work. I will be back when we have it either on or almost on. Okay, I'm back. Right now we're trying to make it work now. Some more modding to the pipe that goes out of the back, I guess. I really don't know what to say. Right now we just cut a little line piece right off the end where we chop the other part of the exhaust.
One chance.
So don't mess it up.
Okay. Don't mess it up.
We just cut this very precisely. Probably not though. But boom. Excuse you. Okay, I'm back and we just cut it. And right now we're trying to find the fitting for it to fit on. I'll be back. Sorry guys, I wasn't paying attention. Right now he's probably going to grind it down some more so it's straighter. Okay, I'm back. Right now we're trying to get the old part of exhaust that goes to the outside of the CDU into the adapter part that we found. Are we welding that together or no? Now we're doing a little trimming on the gasket for the adapter piece. It up right there, and we're trying to get the bigger part of the exhaust to go in the hole right there. And that's what we're doing right now. I'll get back to you when we have the exhaust connected up to that, and we'll be ready to be putting it on. And what we're using to connect all the hoses to each other, we're using clamps. You can get them really much kind of anywhere. And that may be the way we're going, or it depends on if we'll have room or something, or we might not go with that way. We don't know right now.